Keeping data in sync across systems can be a nightmare. And when syncing identities and authorization, email is not a reliable ID because emails can change. So today we'll learn how to model our application databases to use the WorkOS ID as a stable identifier, ensuring that your synced events always land in the right place. Let's get into it. Every user in WorkOS has two identifying pieces of information, their WorkOS user ID and an email address. Now, while an email address can change, a WorkOS ID will not. If you're syncing your users to a database that you own or a backend as a service, IDs may be generated for you. So to properly locate users and sync update and delete events, we need to hold the WorkOS ID in a column of its own. Let's jump back to our code and do that now. This is our Convex public API, where we've defined a route for a WorkOS webhook. If you'd like to see how we got to this point, we have a playlist linked in the card above or the description below. Today, we just want to take what we have and extend it to include a WorkOS ID. Right now, we're only handling the user created event. When that happens, we want to take the ID from the data we're sent and map it to a WorkOS ID in our database. At this point, our create function doesn't accept this as an argument, so we need to update our schema. Open the schema TS file and set a WorkOS ID as a string. With our schema updated, we can go to our users module where we have our create function and update our arguments here as well. WorkOS ID equals args.WorkOS ID. We'll then have to update the type, and we'll use a shorthand for that. Create a user fields variable and define it using schema.tables.users.validator.fields. I know it's a mouthful, and we'll import our schema from our local schema file. And it looks like we're getting an error because I mistyped our schema, which is great. This is why we love type safety. Now we should be ready to go. So let's open up WorkOS and Convex side by side and visit the webhooks page, opening our user webhook and sending a test event. Now, nothing happened, so what gives? Opening up our console, we'll see an error. We've made a change to our schema, but we have data in place that doesn't match that schema. So until we resolve these records, we need to make this WorkOS ID field optional. Let's try this event out again and see what happens. We get a new record. If we scroll over, yes, we see our WorkOS ID. And for our previous record for this email address, unset. At this point, we may need to do some data repair. To learn more about data repair in WorkOS, visit the WorkOS documentation and search for data reconciliation. We offer tools for reconciling data mismatches for any case where an app might get out of sync. We have tools for comparing and aligning data and even replaying missed events. Either way, this is your one-stop shop for fixing data that has gotten out of sync. If you'd like to learn more about the state API and data reconciliation, drop some use cases in the comments below. That would help us know what to prioritize for you. Thanks for watching this series on webhooks. If you have any questions at all, let us know. We'd be happy to make some follow-ups for you. And if you're just learning that this is a series now, well, we'll include links to the playlist so you can catch all of the episodes. That's it for webhooks. I'm Fantastic. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.